Hey, what's up, everybody? Thank you for checking me out. This is Echo Simpson. If this is your first time of watching my videos, please subscribe. Yes, because like I said, I try to bring you stuff, good stuff of what is happening here on the motherland, right? So if you can remember, in May, somewhere in May, I had an interview with this brother right here. Yes, he's a tutor in a technical and vocational institute here in Ghana, all right? So we had an interview, we talked about his project that he wants to, you know, go all out to educate people why we should take technical and vocational training seriously. I hope you remember. So if you remember, just put it up as a comment and say, hey, yes, Echo, I think I watched that video and it was beautiful, yes. So we're going to have a second part of the video to talk about what he's been up to after the first workshop or seminar that included about 500 trainees from around Ghana. Yes, because he is saying that, yes, we can go to school, do the normal training, learning everything, all that, but we need to factor IT skills into whatever we are doing. You know, I know most of you are like, yo, Echo, I want to start a business, buy this, buy that. You are there, but you want to start a business from here. It's all up to getting to know what IT is all about. So, Mr. Elolu, thank you very much for being on my channel
once again. Thank you for coming again. Thank you so much.
Yes. The last time that we met, you had a program for the kids.
Yeah.
Tell us a little bit about that program that you had.
Okay. So once again, greetings to all of you. My name is Elolu. I teach in Ghana's biggest public vocational school, NVTI Briwa or VTRI Briwa. So in the month of May, around 15th of May, I had a convocation where we brought together several schools that are into the vocational and technical field. Mm-hmm. And the main agenda is to understand the role of IT in our vocational education or our technical education. Okay. For a very long time now, you can't be amazing and only know how to use brick and mortar and trowel or a caterer and have no knowledge about IT. The world and the world of work is changed so much that we have to add a level of basic IT education into every course you are doing in a vocational school or in a technical school. So for example, you are a carpentry student. You need to learn how to use some basic software to do some designing.
Okay.
You are doing, for example, catering. You need to learn how to use some basic software or hardware tools to make the catering better. Or you've been doing, for example, welding and fabrication, a very top-notch course today.
Okay.
You need to understand the role of IT in maximizing that, that trade you are learning. Okay. Or you're a teacher in any of these fields. You can't be writing your lesson notes with pen and paper today.
Oh,
you have no idea about virtual education, no idea about software that will make your trade interesting. Yeah. So my agenda is to get everybody in the TVET industry to understand that IT can lift our work so much, can add value, and make sure that our trainees, when they are leaving school, they leave both their hard skills and the soft skills. So when they go out there, they can work very well and earn better income here and there. So that was the whole agenda, and it went very well. You were there yourself.
Yes.
So we had over 15 speakers that day. Yeah. It was marathon. And over 500 students came that day. We had a very good sessions in everything. So after that, we want to see how to take the thing now from the central region now to every part of Ghana. So that's what happened in May.
Okay, beautiful. Yeah. So like you said, you're a carpenter. You need to learn some IT skills that will help you.
Yeah.
I know, you know what? Yeah. There are brothers and sisters from the diaspora who've bought land and stuff here in Ghana.
Wow.
That's and some of them want me to connect them to builders.
Okay.
Now, if you're a builder and you're not IT
compliant,
you know, how would you help such a person? Because the person is there.
Yeah.
You see the thing. So I believe the cause that he's driving at is a beautiful cause that we all have to, you know, support one way or the other.
Yeah.
Now, after this convocation, I know you have visions of, you know, expanding it, taking it to all the 16 regions in Ghana.
Okay.
What have you done so far?
Okay. Thank you so much. So after the program in May, I sent out information to all the schools around the central region and the western region that We want to come now with the concept to their campuses.
Okay.
They don't travel into Brewer.
Mm-hmm.
So God being so good, about 4 schools responded.
Okay.
And they were all private vocational schools.
Private.
One is an ICES school at Asebu.
Mm-hmm.
Asebu on the way to, is it Asinfosu? And okay. also one in Takoradi.
Okay.
So after May, in the month of June and July, mm-hmm. I went to these 2 schools.
Okay.
And we had training in digital skills. How to use Google Classroom,
mm-hmm.
how to use so many applications that are very small
yeah.
on your phones and laptops to make the classroom interesting. There's an app called Brainly.
Brainly.
How a student use that to do assignment at home.
Mm-hmm.
It's an app called InShot. As a student doing catering or any other course, you can take small pictures and videos, add it together, and make it blast it on your social media platform. So I took them through how to use just InShot to do this simple thing, and it was amazing. Come and see, they were holding their phones.
Yeah.
They said, I finished it, I'm done, come and see my video.
Yeah.
And they were excited. Initially, they had no idea mm-hmm. about even how to promote themselves as a student.
Yeah.
But after that program, almost every week, they created their own social media platform.
Yeah.
They upload videos and items, and I can see that this guy, if they continue this way, they'll blow out their profession mm-hmm. and become mighty. So after May, I went to about 2 schools. There are a lot who are still calling.
Yeah.
So now the plan now is that we're going to launch what we call the National Career Convocation.
National
Career Convocation. Yes, what we did was the regional one.
Mm-hmm.
Now this is a national one. Yeah. Now. So for example, in the month of August, as we begin August now,
yeah.
every weekend in August, we are going somewhere.
Okay.
Then September 2. Annapolis. So October, for example, is reserved for all the schools in the Volta region.
Wow, Volta region.
Volta region. So in October, all the weekends in October,
okay.
every weekend from Central, you are driving all the way to
Volta region.
To Volta wow. region. Maybe November will come out to Accra.
Okay.
They are giving the Accra date in Accra okay. so that we can do that for them as well. The plan is that by December, you have one major program in Accra
okay.
to bring all those guys around mm-hmm. together in Accra.
Mm-hmm.
So we are hoping that in December we have the 1 day for the national event itself
okay.
where all the schools will come that day for a mighty mega program
wow.
in December. So there's a lot to be done.
There's a lot to be done. Today is 2nd
August
2021. So this is the current video that we are shooting out. Right now.
Yeah.
Yes.
Yeah.
So I know when all these things that you've talked about comes with, you know, cost, preparations, budget items, and all that. How are you financing all these projects?
Okay.
Do you have the government backing you in any way?
That's a good one. Government is doing their own thing at their own levels. This is a private sector initiative.
Okay.
Uh-huh. So what I do is I talk to friends,
mm-hmm.
just to understand the need for IT in the technical space. And they come on board to support.
Okay.
For a very long time, it's been a personal, you know, project. But as time goes on, I open up everything mm-hmm. to friends and partners and other people who are also into the similar thing. So whenever I'm going out, I send out invitations mm-hmm. and calls to friends who want to support.
Mm-hmm.
Either bear the transport fare for us,
okay.
or get some internet data for mm-hmm. our modems and routers okay. around. Or I talk to those who I know, who are my bosses as well,
mm-hmm.
who understand things like this. And they come around, some supply materials to use, some also give some little cash and little support. So it's a private sector initiative. Government hand is not in it. I call on friends. For example, the last program we did in May, I didn't take any money from anybody.
Okay.
It was myself, you, my friends who came together. Yeah. We brought our resources and it went mighty, and that is a mode of financing it.
Mm-hmm.
You call on people who are like-minded, who understand the need to do it, and they help.
Okay.
Yeah, so I'm trusting that even the ones although they are larger and bigger ones, still we can finance by calling on those who believe in the dream
mm-hmm.
and those who want to support and grow through your initiative. Some of your friends came on board to help me. I never knew them.
Yeah.
But through the video we did with the first video.
Okay.
I want to thank all those who send there. I don't have the names in mind. Those who supported by somebody sent money to buy tablets
and
that we used for the last one.
Wow.
And that guy sent money to do something else.
Yeah.
So I want to thank all those who did that.
Wow.
I have your records in my emails. I've acknowledged all of you.
Great.
And our doors are still open for anybody on the supply as maybe tablets or mobile devices or routers or modems
mm-hmm.
to facilitate internet connectivity mm-hmm. whenever you go to the places around.
Beautiful. So hey, I want to say thank you to everybody who supported my brother, you know, through the video that we did. You know, I believe he's doing his bet. You know, you know me, I'm building a library from my school.
Yeah, yeah.
And it's not... It has nothing to do with the government. Yeah, you know, sometimes I personally don't want to rely on the government. I know some of you will say, yes, it is the duty of the government to build a library and all that. He's not doing it. They are not doing it. So what do? Do you want to sit and watch? No. So that is what he's also doing. You know, if everybody, one way or the other, will come out personally to start a project to develop wherever they are.
I don't think we would put pressure on the government.
So I want to thank everybody who has been supporting my brother and also supporting me build my library. Okay. All right. So before we go, if you have anything that you want to say to anybody, you can go ahead and do that.
Thank you so much. So on my personal level as well, I run a little group that helps students who have finished the vocational schools into employment.
Okay.
So if you are there looking for anybody who is a carpenter, a mason, a caterer, a builder, a welder, any skilled person,
okay,
my email is under there. Just send me. Maybe you want somebody to do something for you in Ghana here, okay, who is a skilled person.
Okay.
Just let me know. I have a link of students who have finished school,
okay,
and they are looking for opportunities like that. So. Okay. I run a small group that on the finish school, they register with me,
mm-hmm,
and then any work I get around, okay, I link them to go and work. So just like an employment agency.
Okay.
If you're there, you're looking for any skilled worker, electrician, a builder, a contractor, a carpenter, a welder, a motor vehicle mechanic, an IT guy, you just give me a message in my email. I'll link them up to you. They are very skilled professional guys,
okay,
and they will work and make sure your project is delivered. And your work is done. But thank you all for supporting us. They are great thing to do for Ghana and for the TV sector as well. I want to thank all of you and God bless all of you.
Yes. You know what? I'm going to give you the first employment or work for those guys.
Thank you.
Yes.
Thank you.
So I have a father. Thank his you. Name is Len. Thank you. Thank Len you. Is building in Asebu.
Okay.
The freelance.
Okay.
Len okay. is building. And okay. Okay. He asked me to send a carpenter to go do these things. So we will need some guys to be, you know, part of the main carpenter guys. So, you know, this is why we need to connect. So I'm going to give him, and I'm going to make a video of that.
Thank
so you see that
you.
I'm for real,
okay,
that I'm giving his boys the first job in their life.
Boys and girls, they're all available.
Beautiful, beautiful. Available. So, hey, thank you very much for checking us out. Put up a comment. Let me know what you think about connecting with brothers and sisters here on the motherland and then learning the vocational and then technical skills. Charles, bye-bye.
Thank you. Bye-bye.